जब पीढ़ियां बदलती हैं तो विचार बदलते हैं, और जब विचार बदलते हैं तो फिल्म निर्माण की जो जो बारीकियां हैं उसमें भी कहीं ना कहीं बदलाव आ जाता है। अभी इस वक्त इन कॉन्वर्सेशन सेशन इसी विषय में आयोजित होना है, द कंटेम्प्रेरी फिल्म मेकर्स ऑफ डिफरेंट जनरेशन।
एब्सोल्युटली, राहुल रवेल, इम्तियाज अली, टू एमिनेंट फिल्म मेकर्स आर इन मैकिनेस वन। लेट्स गो लाइव अक्रॉस देयर।
अवार्ड विनिंग डायरेक्टर मिस्टर इम्तियाज अली। To take this session forward, we have a leading anchor, poet, chat show host, and a theater actor. Please welcome our moderator for the session, Ms. Atika Faruqi. Now I would request Mr. Amit Satija, CEO, Entertainment Society of Goa, and Mr. Ankur Lahoti, Assistant Director, Directorate of Film Festival, to please present mementos to our esteemed guests. Now I hand over the mic to our moderator. Thank you.
So, you know, so there is a little twist, I'll tell you what. Life is basically cinema with all the boring things edited out. You agree with this? Yes. Faiz Ahmed Faiz ka ek sher tha, wo log bahut khush kismat the jo ishq ko kaam samajhte the ya kaam se aashiqui karte the. हम जीते जी मसरूफ रहे, कुछ इश्क किया कुछ काम किया। आज जो दो शख्सियतें सिनेमा जगत की हमारे साथ हैं, उन्होंने अपने अपने दौर में, अपने अपने करियर के शुरुआती दौर में अपनी अपनी फिल्मों के साथ हमें नए तरीके से इश्क करना सिखाया। विद फिल्म्स लाइक बेताब, लव स्टोरी, और इम्तियाज जी का तो पूरा करियर आप जानते ही हैं। इनकी फिल्में थोड़ा इश्क, थोड़ा मुश्क, थोड़ी रंजिश, थोड़ा इनकलाबी तेवर, थोड़ी बेताबी, प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ द यूथ, सब कुछ एक मिक्सचर देखा गया है, राइट? आज हम इन सबको एक्सप्लोर करेंगे, लेकिन इम्तियाज जी के अंदर का जर्नलिस्ट आज जाग गया है और वो कुछ बातें उनसे ऐसी करना चाहते हैं जिसमें शायद तीसरे की ज़रूरत नहीं है। सो फर्स्ट दे विल हैव अ कॉन्वर्सेशन विद इन देमसेल्व्स एंड देन आई विल जॉइन देम फॉर अ कॉन्वर्सेशन।
Thank you very much, Atika. The moral of the story is that we often have interviews in which the same questions are asked again and again, and we have the same answers, and we start to think that our life is really boring. A very interesting avenue presented itself, sir, when you called me up and said, why don't you come as a guest to IFFI? And I must share the story here, that I said to him that I'll definitely come since you've called, but my request is that let me interview you. So this is a dream come true for me. I come from a smaller town than most of you, I think, where it was impossible, especially during those times, to even imagine what the film industry would be. And I came into the film industry in early 2000s. My first film was released in 2005. And then I found this to be a place of dreamers and drifters and losers like myself. And I fit right in.
I wish there were more losers like you.
But I think, as far as cinema is concerned, the more important millennium in my life was the previous one, before I became a filmmaker, when I was watching films. At that point of time, when I had no idea how films are made, I was getting influenced by cinema in a very drastic way. And I think that who I am and what my cinema is, and in many ways, just a reflection of the influences of my youth. One of the big influences of my youth have been a few films that have been made by this gentleman on the right. And I would like, in this time where I think film industry tends to be very myopic, you know, we move across directors very soon, you know. Atika mentioned a poem by Fez. And I'll mention a poem by Billy Joel, which says that I am the entertainer and I know just where I stand. Another serenader, another long-haired band. Today I am the champion. Today I am the champion. I may have won your hearts, but I know the game. You'll forget my name and I won't be here in another year if I don't stay on the charts. So sometimes to bring value to our own cinema, we have to look back at what has influenced us to become filmmakers. And in this respect, I would like to throw light on two films of yours. There are so many films, there are so many questions I have, but I thought it'll be an idea to focus on two of them, sir. Arjun and Daket.
Okay.
But before we start talking, let me ask you, how was your childhood? What was Rahul Rawail the kid?
A person who did not want to become a filmmaker.
But your father was a filmmaker?
Yeah, I know, dad was a filmmaker, but I was not keen. I wanted to become, please don't laugh, a nuclear physicist.
That's a neurophysicist? Yeah. Nuclear physicist.
That's my dream. And Rishi Kapoor, Chintu, a childhood friend.
Okay.
And they were starting shooting the circus portion of Menam Joker. So he called me and said, your exams are over. I was a 15-year-old. So come, let's go and watch the shooting. The Russians are here. So I said, what will you do with the shooting? He said, look, they're all Russian females. Unhone chote chote kapde pehne honge. It'll be great to come and watch them. So that was the intention of going to watch that shooting, to see women in skimpy little clothes.
So that was the promise of cinema.
That was the promise of cinema. But I went there and I saw Raj Kapoor working for the first time. And that one day, you know, changed my entire outlook. And watching him work and then going over and over again, I decided to become a filmmaker if I could. So that's where the journey went from.
But you are pretty much a Bombay boy, sir. You was born and brought up in Bombay.
Absolutely. Absolutely Bombay.
I remember, I think Betab was released in 1985.
Betab was 84.
Yes. Arjun was...
Betab was 83, sorry.
Right. I have it written over here.
Arjun was 85.
Arjun was 85, right. So I remember that I was in school those days. And some of my friends in school, we were staying over at my house, and those days we used to hire a VCR. And we got many films to watch. I can't name all of them. But one of the movies was Arjun. We watched Arjun at 1 o'clock at night. It got over at 4. We started it again when it got over. And 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock in the morning, we had seen it 2 times. We literally came out on the street trying to pick a fight with everybody. Ki marte hain kisi ko sala. And I'll tell you, I'd seen many films before that. I had no idea what Bombay was, what is the true life in Bombay, what does a young person feel. And I'd like to play a clip for you guys to have a taste of that. And then I can ask some more questions from you, sir.
The first one that I told you.
This film was made in 1985.
लाइट ऑफ होगा, ये दो लाइट ऑफ हो सकते हैं.
थैंक यू.
अर्जुन, तुम लोग यहाँ क्या कर रहे हो?
मेरे लिए बैठे यार.
तू यहाँ मत घूम, घर जा.
क्यों, क्या बात है?
अरे बहुत बड़ा लफड़ा हो गया, उरंगा के आदमी तुझे ढूंढ रहे हैं. तीन चार बार टैक्सी में भी चक्कर मार के गए. थोड़ी थोड़ी देर बाद काका की दुकान पे आते तेरे लिए पूछने के लिए.
एक काम कर अर्जुन, तू घर चला जा वरना लफड़ा हो जाएगा.
मैं काका की दुकान पे जाके बैठता, देखो तो मुझे कौन ढूंढ रहा है.
अर्जुन मेरी बात सुन, अर्जुन तू घर जा, अरंगा के छोड़ के ढूंढ रहे हैं.
मैं जानता हूँ काका.
अरे कहाँ जा रहा है तू, क्या करने वाला है भाई?
मैं उन लोगों का इंतजार करूंगा काका.
What are your feelings, sir?
Let me concede it, very proud of this one film. And it was, I think the atmosphere which got created was what really worked for the film. And of course, bring back a lot of memories. I've got some tears in my eyes remembering those days.
What are those? Share some of them with us. What do you remember?
Arjun was a film which had one thing which was a great way to start it off, was that Javed Akhtar wrote it. And for 6 months, we were trying to find a story for a film. We could not find a story. And one day in Khandala, we read an article on the growth of Dawood and the Pathan gang, how they were being exploited and how they were rising. They were just rising at that time. And at night we went to sleep at about 10 o'clock. Javed went to his room. I was in my room, and then I was woken up at 3 in the morning by Javed. And he said, come into my room. I want to narrate something to you. I went to his room. He had this habit of writing on scraps of paper. You know, you'd find a scrap here, he'd go in his pocket, or you'd find on toilet paper written somewhere. And from about 3:30 till 6:30, he narrated the entire script of Arjun Rumi, which was an absolute achievement. In 3 hours, a man had written an entire script. And then we went with it, and what fascinated me was that this was a chance to exploit Bombay like we've never seen before. That was what we wanted to do. Arjun had no great story. It was more character driven. So the visuals, this was all a set. Yeah.
Is this a set?
Yeah, this was all a set.
And then, but bus, cars are going.
They were all hired. They were all hired.
That's incredible. You know, who made this set, sir?
We had an art director called the gentleman is not with us anymore. So this, the whole thing, the BSC buses and the cars and all.
They were all in the studio.
They were all hired and they were in the studio. So, you know, my bus could come and go whenever I wanted it to go. It didn't have to wait for the timings. In fact, a very funny thing happened was my producers thought that this man is wasting too much money on getting a bus standing every day, and he uses it only at times. So they said, you know, we made arrangements we'll get a bus. You tell us when you want it. It'll be there in 2 minutes. So I said, fine, if you find that easy. And we needed a bus. So I said, I want a bus now. And we had to wait for 2.5 hours because they couldn't find a bus. So that's why, that's how we created the character. And the streets were all, you know, the shops, everything was
but
all put
for
up.
For you to have a grasp on how it is to live in that chal where Arjun lived, you know, and the terrace, your lifestyle, I'm sure, was different from that, like from the Malvankar family. But how did you get the insight that they live like this or their relationships are like this?
There was a lot of traveling I used to do by the local trains.
Okay.
You know, that was my means of transport. And at times one would go into Parel, which is where it's supposed to be based.
Okay. Incidentally, I've lived there when I came into Bombay
first.
So
you must be knowing more about what Parel was. And that's how it just came about. And we tried to create an atmosphere where even a camel was, you know, you see camels walking on the streets in Bombay.
Oh, really?
And yeah, so we had a camel brought in. It took 2 days to reach there, poor chap. We had to walk. And my producers always complained that we paid so much money for the camel and we could see it only one shot. I said, now then.
But in the next film that I'm going to show, there are going to be many camels. So let's have a look at that clip. That's from Dakeet.
Okay.
So
it's not, just show me. I may have udhar rakhe.
So the producer of Arjun will be very happy to see this clip. This is just for him. So that's more camels than we had ever seen before.
If we're going to show more sequences from the old films, you'll have very shortly see an old man crying. So I think we should put a stop to that.
This, what do you remember about Dakeet, sir?
Dakeet, to me, is a film which was probably my best work. There's no doubt about that. And getting into the Ramayans.
Yeah, I always wanted to ask you that you had no connection with Chambal or with Bhind Morena, etc. How did you connect so nicely with it?
See, when the script was done, there were sequences which had to be done in the Ramayans.
But first, how did the script even come about? And how were you interested in that story?
It was something between, with Javed and me, and worked out together. You know, where we didn't want the dacoit to be with a pagadi and a tika, what we'd seen.
Right.
And we wanted to see, know what the dacoits really are. Hmm. So we went across, Javed, me, and Kuku Kohli is here. He was an associate with me on the film. We went to Gwalior, and we went to Gwalior Jail, and spent 2 days with Pullan Devi over there. And she was instrumental in guiding us through all the locations. You know, things which were in our mind, ki, we need something like this. You know, it's very easy for a writer or a director to sit in a room and imagine a place, and it may not be there, but they were there. She guided us through, she told us of how characters, how dacoits were on the run, how they'd be chased by the police, and the different locations we had, like I needed a place where I wanted a fort with the ravines. And she pinpointed everything on her.
So this was coincidental that you thought of a location, you didn't know whether it existed.
Yeah, and we then, knew the ravines.
But it did exist, and Pullan Devi told you that it does.
It does, because she knew the whole thing absolutely, you know, back of her hand.
So after thousands of films on dacoits that had been made before, suddenly there was this film which broke the mold. And as we know, there was Bandit Queen later, which was extremely authentic, same terrain, based on the life of Pullan Devi, incidentally, who was your guide. But anything else that you think you must have done in these films that made them different from the ones before them?
I think shot them honestly. That made all the difference.
What? Sorry, again?
I said shot them honestly. They were shot from the bottom of the heart. And the only way you can make a film which is when it comes from the heart. And Paresh Rawal's character in Dacoit, I don't think too many have much seen it.
We'll but show a clip of that also.
Of Paresh
Rawal in Dacoit.
That character, which became iconic, was suggested by Pullan Devi. She suggested this kind of a cop who existed in that place. And if Coco remembers, we went to Morena to scout locations. We met a cop who's exactly like that. I mean, we entered and said, you know, where is the SP? And they said, Saab, kal wo yahan par teen daku mare gaye, to unke saath photo khichwa rahe. I mean, that was a strange kind of thing.
Teen daku aane wale hain, unke saath SP saab photo khicha rahe. Wo kal aane wale hai daku, ye aaj photo khicha
rahe. This is strange. It's really strange. This is the country we...
Yeah, live. And then suddenly all of this came into cinema. Incidentally, I was shocked. I was a young boy when I saw Dacoit in Jamshedpur talkies. And I was shocked to see this guy sleeping with the wife of the person who he has caught.
Exactly.
Aur ye sirf matlab uske character ko establish karne ka ploy tha, because that was not the part of the story at all. But it was, he carried that horror through the film because of what he used to do with that woman.
But Imtiaz, I have to remind you one thing. This is a conversation
between
two directors, right? Yeah. And
this has just begun, sir.
It's not Imtiaz talking only about Rahul Rawail.
Of course,
right?
Of course.
So I think we need to get there also. There's one thing about Imtiaz. You know, his films have always been up there for me. It's one honest filmmaker. His honesty shows in all his films. And I don't know if there are too many people who know about this, but there's a short film which he made. It's a 7 or 8 minute short film, which when I mentioned it to him, Imtiaz was quite surprised that I remembered that. And I do, because it's embedded in my memory. I've got a clip of that short film, and I'd like you guys to see it. All right?
It's very long. So it's very long. Do you want to do it at the end of the session or right now?
Long or short? Show it to them now. You don't know.
There are a few more questions I have to ask you, though.
You can ask me anytime. All right. But right now, I'm extremely keen to hold all these people, their kids, I could say, to watch this short film.
Okay.
Sensex crash. जिसने उस वक्त खरीदा वो आज किधर है?
स्टार्टिंग स्टार्टिंग से
उसके पास तो अपना खुद का जहाज है।
हाँ बोल क्या हुआ? अरे पर अभी तो आया था बार में स्टॉक एक्सचेंज से। क्या कह रहा है? क्या बकवास कर रहा है? हाँ ऐसा कैसे गिर गया? मतलब तो क्या गिर गया? क्रैश बोले तो? अरे और एक्सचेंज संक्रमण वो भी? अरे यानी जिधर भी मैंने पैसा डाला था वही स्टॉक डूब गया।
बैंक के शेयर में इन्वेस्ट किया होगा तुम।
ए चुप, ये तेरे बाजार की बात नहीं हो रही है। अच्छा बैंक के सारे शेयर गिर गए? बैंक ऑफ फाइनेंस
बाकी सब भी गिरेगा।
पूरा का पूरा क्रैश
लग गई तेरी। अब तो इस बाजार में दलाली कर।
झापट मारे में मार।
छू के दिखा ना।
अरे ये हुआ कैसे ये तो बता।
यूएस फेडरल रिजर्व रेट बढ़ाया होगा और क्या।
अच्छा फेडरल रिजर्व का करेक्शन है क्या?
ये तो पता था होने वाला है।
पता किसको? क्या पता बाबा? क्या पता?
अंधा है क्या तू? दो हफ्ते से न्यूज में बोले तुझे दिखता नहीं है? इन्फ्लेशन ऊपर है, फिस्कल डेफिसिट इतना बड़ा, तेल के दाम छप्पर फाड़।
तो
यही तो करते हैं रिजर्व वाले। डॉलर की वैल्यू तो रखनी है ना, दुनिया डॉलर पर ही चलती है।
अरे ये डॉलर की वैल्यू मेंटेन करने के लिए सब नाटक है, समझा तू? करना क्या है? क्या क्या करना है? अरे बेचना है। करना क्या है? पहले वो पूल मिल वाला स्टील बेच दो और उसके बाद जो बचा है वो सारा का सारा बेच दो बस।
मतलब तेरा सारा पैसा डूब गया?
अरे जो मिलता है उसे पकड़ो और निकलो।
टोटल लॉस है, बड़े दुख की बात।
तो क्या कर सकते हैं इसमें?
अबे उल्लू यही टाइम है।
क्या क्या टाइम है?
जब कल डिसाइड होता है। कल भी धंधा ही करना है, इधर बेचो उधर खरीदो, तो टके का मुनाफा नुकसान। क्या कल कुछ बनना है?
अरे इधर बना बनाया सब डूब रहा है, कल क्या घंटा बनना है?
देख अब सारी कंपनीज ने इतनी भारी गड़बड़ तो की नहीं होगी ना कि सबका स्टॉक गिरेगा?
नहीं
नहीं ना। तो इसका मतलब क्या है? सुधार आने वाला है?
एक मिनट रुक। अरे पता है रुक। तू इतना श्योरली कैसे कह सकती है?
2008 में क्या हुआ था?
रिसेशन।
लेमन ब्रदर्स बैंकरप्ट, रातों रात एफडीआई का सारा पैसा निकल गया, सेंसेक्स क्रैश। पर जिसने उस वक्त खरीदा वो आज किधर है?
उसके पास तो अपना खुद का जहाज है। मेरा मामा तो होता है वो। अब सुन मेरी बात सुन, अब हम बेचेंगे नहीं खरीदेंगे। कौन सा खरीदना चाहिए?
ब्लू चिप वाले शेयर में सस्ते।
ब्लू चिप वाले सारे शेयर खरीद लो। हां अरे टाटा तरीके वो इंफोसिस और वो
एलएनटी
बीएचईएल
हिंदुस्तान लीवर
टाटा मोटर्स एक्सेट्रा। अरे मेरा मतलब है इन सारे शेयर पर लगा दो, सारा का सारा लगा दो, टोटल लगा दो। अरे श्योर से भी ज्यादा श्योर, 1 करोड़ टका श्योर। देख यही है मौका, लगा दो चौका। जय भारती जी। तू स्टूडेंट है क्या? क्लास करती है क्या तू फाइनेंस की? तो बन सकती है तू इन्वेस्टमेंट बैंकर, बता रहा हूं मैं।
एक बात कहो।
हाँ बोल।
तू मेरी चिंता तो मत कर, अपना मैं खुद ही संभाल लूंगी। अपनी सोच, 6.5 मिनट बाकी बचे हैं, जो करना है जल्दी करो, निकल यहां से चल।
Well, Imtiaz, this was one short film which really is embedded in my mind. You were quite surprised when I remembered it.
Yeah, I've completely forgotten about this, actually.
No, I did not. And I think it would be very foolish if somebody forgot this film.
Yeah, because I really, absolutely, before, because when I called you and you reminded me, I had trouble in placing it, actually.
Yeah, I know. I realized that because the nuances here of a prostitute talking on the financial crisis, and she talks about the recession, the stock markets, what shares would go up, what would not go up. And what I loved about it is in the climax, in the end, when the guy asks her, are you a student? She doesn't reply. She says, look, I've got 6.5 minutes left. So that's what really got to me. And I wish there were more short films like this.
Thank you, sir. And, thank you for showing it to me.
No, I really wanted to show it. And on your films, I've watched your films right from the beginning. You have this great thing of travel, how you take your films on a journey. I still film your, feel your best film was Sochanatha.
Sir, much of my travel is because I'm inspired by movies that you made, that J.P. Datta made, that were shot outside Bombay, in places like Bhind Morena, in places like Rajasthan, like J.P. sir used to shoot. So it really inspired me to go there. Because incidentally, in 1985, another movie was released, which was Ghulami.
Ghulami.
So that was they shot in Rajasthan for that. So it's films like that that influenced me to actually go out and shoot. And then when you go out and shoot, then you learn more things, and then you know that leads to another journey. So really, it's really coming. It's a reflection of your films that my films have traveled.
No, Imtiaz, I'm. It is very kind of you to say that. But,
no, really, I mean it.
But
I'm not.
Let me be honest about one thing. The kind of quality you have of saying things a lot in a visual, you know, is something very rare. We have directors, I don't want to be offensive, but who rely on, you know, on speaking, you know, on the oral side of it. I remember your film Highway, after Alia's kidnapped, and she's in the truck in the day. And there was this one shot, I wish I had it here, where she just leans out of the window and looks out and has this particular and a peculiar smile on her face. It's the first time the girl realizes what a free life is, though she's been kidnapped. For me, that was absolutely brilliant. I mean, I was the one person in the theater who stood up and clapped. For me, it was a moment of standing ovation. I will not forget that. I will not forget a shot in your film with Bebo and Shahid.
Jab We Met.
We've seen lots of films shot in the snow.
Right.
But there was one shot in that song where she's singing with her back. You know, she's standing with her back to the Jeep and Shahid is driving and she's singing. And the camera is going through this whole patch of snow. And now for me, that shot made me feel cold, which is great because the director could really bring that expression out. It's very rare. And you've done it. You've done it multiple times. You've done it every time. You got away with Rishi Kapoor being played in a flashback by Saif Ali Khan. I really want to know how you manage that.
Yeah, man. I don't know. I think people just like to believe. I think the only...
No, it was seamless. Nobody even pointed this out. How did, you know, because suddenly Rishi Kapoor was not there and... Stephanie Khan was there. So, you know, you had this great...
I really feel because I, as I'm saying, started my journey in a small city watching films on a large screen, films by directors like yours. And you go into the cinema theater to believe and to enjoy. You know, that audience, like, they don't go in there to challenge anything. All they want is to be entertained and to be taken on a journey, to be taken on a ride.
Yeah, you actually go and believe when you are convinced that what you are seeing, you are convinced of what's happening there.
Yeah.
You're right? If you're not convinced, the audience is going to ask you 10 questions.
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely.
Why has this happened? With Highway, I had a great connect because somewhere the atmosphere of the hut where they lived reminded me of Betab.
Yes, because it's in the same terrain. You shot in the Betab. So there is a place in Pahalgam, for those who have gone to Kashmir and to Pahalgam, there's a place which is called the Betab Valley. That is because of his film Betab.
Yeah.
So this scene that he's talking about, it reminds him of Betab because it is shot in Aru, which is just ahead of Pahalgam. So it's close to Betab Valley.
And since I've seen that area, I filmed there, it was very real. You know, that's the kind of houses they live in.
They call it dhoka.
Yeah. And all your films, Rockstar, I think gave a different dimension to music. And Ranbir Kapoor, I think, has one of his best performances.
That reminds me, sir, the background music of Arjun. It was very unconventional. So while you were making it, did you face resistance? Who came up with these ideas? Who was the background music director?
The background music was run by Pancham, Hardy Burman.
Yes.
He did all the background and that one sequence.
How did this very different sound come? Like, I have so many clips, but I think we might not have time and we should get Atika on stage fast. But how did it come to his mind or to your mind that we should have background like this with that ha 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 sound and all
of
that.
Yeah, I know, in that umbrella
sequence. Do we have time? Can we show that one sequence, please? Yeah. Now, please, I'd like you to see many sequences from his films. I've got 8. Atika, we'll just do
why
this.
Why don't you just show them the films? Instead of showing them only.
Just this umbrella sequence, we must, and go, listen to the background music, okay? I'm telling you, there was no human sounds ever in background music before this. Just listen to this. So many umbrellas were bought by the producer for this one.
Yeah. We had 1,000 people holding 2,000 umbrellas. That was R.D. Burman.
You know, that is his voice.
And that whole sequence got uplifted, you know, 20 times, courtesy Pancham. One has to give him credit for that.
Yes, of course. But also some shots like that. I remember the shot the one with just the hand and the
I'll just
sword
a short,
above the umbrella.
Background to this sequence. I was an assistant director in RK, and Raj Sahib used to go to Pune to shoot, and he'd like to take the Deccan Queen, which is a train which runs from VT. He liked to go on to that because there were good things to eat on it. So he would, you know, go there.
Yeah.
And the train leaves at 5 in the evening. So I would come there sometimes earlier. And there's a lane opposite VT where in the monsoons, I would see this visual of, you know, a whole lane just being covered with umbrellas. You know, the multicolor umbrellas were not there at that time, thank God.
Right.
So they were just umbrellas. And that stayed somewhere in my mind. And also on the other side, on one evening, me and my wife were coming back on Linking Road at about 3 in the morning. And across the road, we saw a man running. It was very fearsome seeing him, and he was being chased by 10 guys with swords.
Wow.
And he was running through the cars from where I was.
Okay.
All I could see were the top of the cars and the top of the swords.
Whoa.
I could not see the people behind. Oh. That was a stunning visual. So when this came up, you know, we thought of amalgamating the two, and that's how the sequence really came out.
It's a wonderful story. There are so many questions, but I think I'll have to come to your house again and ask them.
Yes, you're most welcome anytime, but I think I need to ask you a question.
Okay.
How do you do it over and over again? You've
come
done
on,
it.
Sir, come
you
on.
Got to tell me how you
I've
do it.
I've not even started talking about Love Story or Betab or any of these films. So we'll talk later.
Know, if we get in this mutual admiration society,
then it'll become more interesting for the audience.
Next 3 days in the festival time, just going through this. But this work which you are doing, Imtiaz, and you've done, has been extremely gratifying. And for a student of cinema, I still consider myself a student because I think you do not learn everything. If you say you know everything, that means you don't. So you learn watching films.
Sure.
And then you see how other people are working. And what you really pick out is the nuances. You know, it's not the major sequences, it's the nuances.
Yeah, that's true.
Which really, and they really stay back in your mind, which has happened in all your films. You know, I have a long list of things which should be really spoken about. So tell me now, how do you, can we have Atika come?
Yeah, we'll, this is a good time to call.
Yeah, can we have Atika?
Atika.
Please give her a big
stage.
Hand. And
thank you very much for being so patient.
Mughal-e-Azam to ho gayi, ab keh rahe hain picture banao, bataiye. I as a woman, when I see Imtiaz's films, and Rahul ji, aapki film mein bhi hum logon ne bachpan mein dekhi thi.
Achha, why does everybody have to tell me how old I am? Because aap keh rahe hain aapki bachpan mein dekhi thi. Imtiaz kehta hai, jab main bachcha tha, maine film dekhi thi. Why do you have to repeat this all the time?
So I think the young audience over here has to all promise to watch Rahul ji's films. Definitely watch Arjun, and my favorite is also Dakait, sir. Definitely watch these films and then call him and say, sir, maine aapki film kal hi dekhi hai.
Oh God.
एक दिलचस्प बात मुझे ये लगती है 1970s का जो दौर था उसमें एंग्री यंग मैन की शुरुआत हुई थी देयर वाज दिस राइज ऑफ मैस्कुलिनिटी हाई टेस्टोस्टेरोन ऑन सेल्यूलॉइड आपकी हालांकि पहली फिल्म 1980 में आई थी लेकिन विद लव स्टोरी एंड देन बेताब अगेन अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ अ रीइंफोर्समेंट ऑफ दिस यंग बॉय फुल ऑफ यूथ बेटा बाप से कह रहा है कि मैं घर छोड़ के भाग जाऊंगा बाप कह रहा है मैं तुझे जाने ही नहीं दूंगा वो रिबेलियन था नाउ कट टू इम्तियाज़ फिल्म्स मैंने आप को अभी मैं बता रही थी कि मैंने आपको ये मैसेज किया था. घर पे चलती रहती हैं, टीवी पे आती रहती हैं इम्तियाज़ की फिल्में, और मैं ऐसे हर बार जब मैंने इनकी फिल्म देखी, एक बात मैंने नोट की, इनकी फिल्मों में जो लड़का होता है वो फूट फूट के रोता है. बहुत बहुत बड़ा स्टेटमेंट है ये. आपने रियलाइज़ किया है जो प्रोटैगनिस्ट होता है, जो हीरो होता है, वो बिंदास, बिना मुंह छुपाए, बिना आँखों पे हाथ रखे फूट फूट के रोता है अपनी हीरोइन के सामने. हाईवे में वो एक सीन जिसमें वो उसको एक छोटी सी झोपड़ी मिल जाती है, एंड में वो कहती है बाहर आओ मैं उसको सजा रही हूँ. फिर वो अंदर आने लगता है, फिर हाँ बाहर जाओ, मैगी बन गई है, सब मैंने साफ कर दिया, अब आ जाओ. वो अंदर आता है रणदीप, और वो एक खूबसूरत सा घर जो कि झोपड़ी वॉज टर्न इन टू अ ब्यूटिफुल हाउस, उसको देख के बाहर ऐसे फूट फूट के रोता है. न जाने क्यों, कोई तो बात थी जो आप कहना चाह रहे थे लेकिन आप साफ साफ नहीं कह रहे थे. लेकिन आदमी और औरत की जो रिलेशनशिप है, और ख़ास तौर से आदमी का जो पोर्ट्रेयल है जिस तरह से आपने दिखाया अपनी फिल्मों में, आई कैन स्पीक ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ वुमेन दैट आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल टू यू. और क्या ये इत्तफाकन हुआ या देर इज़ अ पीस ऑफ योर लाइफ देयर और एनी इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ योर हैपनिंग ऑफ योर लाइफ, ऐसा ये कॉमन क्यों है फिल्मों में?
Well, I feel it is said that cinema is aspirational. I think cinema is also aspirational for the writers and the directors that make that cinema. I feel that in their movies, in our movies, we try to do those things that we have been unable to do in life. I have never been able to cry. At least before, as a young man, I have never. I used to feel, my mother used to tell me that I'm heartless. As a joke, but the fact that I never had that, and it was, sometimes I felt like, but I couldn't do the physical reaction of crying, you know. And maybe aap keh rahi hain, I've never thought of it before, but then as you pointed this thing out, it must be because of certain aspiration that I might have had to come to that level of catharsis. And I feel that most good things in life are facilitated by women. The only way that anybody could reach that stage is because of a certain softness, a certain love that only a woman is capable of giving, I think. And I might be biased. My interest is not in myself or in men as much as it is in women. I'm very fascinated by women of all kinds. I was guilty to admit it earlier. Now I'm old enough to say that on a stage. I find them very beautiful, very sensitive, and provocative.